Hi everybody, it's Coach Elizabeth here with Monday Morning Manifestation, and today we're going to talk about how to effortlessly allow success into your life. It sounds pretty great, right? Well, it all starts with two words, and those are let go. Now, I know what you guys may be thinking. You may be thinking, well, if I want to be successful in my life and have all of this abundance and attract the right people and the right opportunities, I have to just really put my nose to the grindstone. I have to really work hard. I have to break through obstacles and kind of force it into reality. Well, from my experience at least, it has been the complete opposite of that. The more I try to control situations or perceptions of me, or what I wanted bosses or buyers or coworkers or friends or boyfriends to do, it really always kind of blew up in my face. So I just wanted to chat a little bit today about how the art of letting go can really finally let that tidal wave of success wash over you that you all divinely deserve. So the first thing that happens when we start letting go is that we really start to release a lot of those feelings of fear and judgment. So why are fear and judgment bad? I mean, I think we know that they're all bad, but more specifically, how they block your blessings is because when you're coming from a place of fear and judgment and control, you're really taking your existence and creating resistance. So if you've watched any of the other videos, you know that resistance is the equal and opposing force to any sort of growth or breakthrough that you're trying to have. You're always going to be met with a little bit of resistance. I almost see it as almost kind of like a little test to make sure you really want what you want. So the bigger the thing is that we're going for, the more resistance you can expect. So resistance will start to pop up when you start to have fear and judgment because you're not really dwelling from this place of trust. So the universe says, I have all of this bounty of abundance for you. I want you to live your best life, right? So when we don't believe that and we start trying to control shit, we bring resistance into our life, right? Because we're going against the grain. We're going against what your soul and what the universe wants you to do, which is just be, as Oprah calls it, in the flow of your life, right? It wants you to go with the flow. But in doing so, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't have really high goals for yourselves or expectations for your life, or that you can just sit back in a chair and let the universe, you know, serve everything up to you. It's not really quite that easy. What we really need to do is get super clear on what those goals are. So one of the first things I do when I work with clients is I ask them what their goals are. And, you know, a lot of people aren't real sure, and that's okay. But hopefully if you're watching this, this will inspire you to get a little bit of clarity around what you want. Because the universe and this wonderful source energy, this vibrational energy that's just waiting to bring us things, can't bring you something if you're not telling it what to bring. If you don't even know what you want, it can't be provided to you. So if you start to get clarity around what you want, you ask, and then you really believe, you will receive. I know everybody's heard that before, but I swear to God, it works. But the thing people get hung up on is the believing, right? Because when we believe, we have to let go. We have to trust that it is owed to us and that it is coming to us. And a lot of people get hung up on that. They think, if I just try to control this situation a little bit, or if I just try to manipulate this person into giving me what I want, then I'll get it. And you know, you might for a little bit, but it'll be temporary and it'll never be as good as it could possibly be if you just let the universe figure it out for you. You have to have the goal. What you don't have to understand is the how. Okay? Because the universe will send you, I tell my clients, they'll send you breadcrumbs and you just have to follow them. You just have to start taking baby steps in the direction that your soul and that source energy and that the universe is telling you to go. And when you start taking that action, the next step will unfold. It will all come into your awareness and your visibility. And another way to manifest these feelings of clarity is through meditation. So I know there's probably two groups of people out there, people who live and die by meditation, and then people who kind of don't get it or say they don't have time or they think it's kind of bullshit. But in order to get clarity on the goals that you really want and that your soul is aligned to bring you, you really do have to create a space of consciousness for those messages to come, for those messages to come through. And that's nearly impossible to do if you have earbuds in all the time, or if you're just kind of living unconsciously and you're kind of keeping busy so that you can sort of numb out to what your soul is begging you to do. So that's my tip for this week. Try to find an area of your life where you can completely let go and surrender. You can just go with the flow. It can be something really minor as, you know, I might sit in traffic today or I might not, but either way, I'm going to enjoy the ride. It's going to be a fantastic day. Or it can be something much larger that you're struggling with. Everybody's always struggling with something. It really is peaceful to let it go, and you will be astounded at what the universe will serve up for you. It's always way better than you ever thought it could be.